Piarco. Hey guys. Yeah, mate, I'll check later perhaps that song. Time for morning coffee, boys. Time for coffee. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Just finished watching a podcast, Tinfoil Hat with Eddie Bravo. It was pretty good. They didn't focus on anything specifically, just a whole range of conspiracy theories. I haven't heard about the cruise ship, but it wouldn't surprise me if that did happen. Second, I just need to check if there's an update for the Twitch app. Wait up. Okay, so there's several places with ships quarantined. Oh yeah, I think yesterday someone mentioned something about a cruise ship, and Nismo said that he'd seen that boat in Sydney before. Raw egg with Dr. Pepper? That's messed up, dude. Hey, Sata Sikasi, hey man. Ants Corp. Yeah, we're okay. We're all good out here so far. You know, I was just oh my god, I was just listening to the radio, and there was some guy, I don't know where he was from, but he was saying how the World Health Organization, their official statement is that if you're healthy, you don't need to wear a mask. Only, I don't know if this is true, but this is what this guy said. If you're healthy, you don't need to wear a mask, but if you're sick, you should wear one. don't eat many chips and stuff like that. But yeah, Doritos I have had a few times before. I don't mind Doritos, I guess. Doritos and salsa, that's not bad. But yeah, I guess if you like cottage cheese, Doritos and cottage cheese would be pretty good. Pepper. Oh, Pepper, don't knock the camera, be careful. Oh my god, Pepper. What are you doing? Hi Pepper, hi Pepper, hi. Who's a pretty cat? Who's a pretty girl? Who's a pretty girl? What are you doing? You want to see me? Be careful. So they're definitely keeping somewhat of a lid on it, right? So what did I hear? So the first doctor that reported this coronavirus, right? He's now dead from it, right? And another six doctors that have spoken about the virus are apparently now detained by the China government. Hey, Grace Love. So we're at pretty low bitrate right now using the Yi camera. It's only at like just 2000, as you guys can see in the bottom corner there. But I don't know what it's going to look like on a big TV, on like a 40-inch, 50-inch TV. But I got a feeling the quality isn't too bad. Especially if you're watching on like a smaller device. Yeah, so people were saying something about some cure or something for treating it, but I haven't really heard much more about that. What's up, betches? Hey, Captain Barabbas, how's things, man? We're just chilling out here. It's another nice day, not too warm at all. Hey, yeah, long time. Well, a little while anyway. God damn it. Poggers. I don't think that's the cure. You can try that, see how that goes, but I don't think that's gonna work. Yeah, a little bit overcast today, but I'd say there's a very little chance of rain. No chance of rain. Just a little foggy over the mountain there. I took up some of the rubbish. I took up like 5 big bags of rubbish. Oh, my cactus. The cactus that I transplanted here. Well, I guess the tip looks a little bit light green. That might be some new growth, possibly, after I put it in here. Maybe. But these things, nothing, nothing. There's one streamer that's an actual scientist, a biologist, and he did a stream where he looked up the genome of this new virus and did a search through this database of similar viruses, and I think it matched up with SARS, that it was like 70-something% the same. Hey, my quad. Adam Boo, welcome. I think my girlfriend is freaking out a bit. She went on Amazon last night and ordered these masks, these like crazy gas mask things. They're like these mini gas masks. It's been pretty dry, Porgers. It's been pretty dry. My nose has been fairly dry. Nose and throat. But similar to every other year. Yes, yeah, Sada, let's hope they can get it all under control. I went back to the supermarket today, still everything sold out, no cleaning products, no paper towels, no toilet paper. did buy some vegetables and some steak though. So yeah, I'm curious how long, all of Hong Kong doesn't have toilet paper or paper towels. Oh, and today, there was another huge line of people lined up outside Japan Home. I imagine they got a shipment of masks in, and people are all lining up to buy them. But yeah, I wonder how long it's gonna take till Hong Kong gets some more toilet paper. Buying up all the Coca-Cola. Dude, Hong Kong is a little crazy. It's how it's spread. True, true. I think it's like a bad time of year that it happened as well, at Chinese New Year, when basically all of China goes on holiday. And also I guess the fact that this virus, it can not show any symptoms for 2 weeks, but be contagious in those 2 weeks. So you can spread it to a bunch of people and you don't even know you have it. I think there's even cases where people have contracted it, spread it, but never developed any symptoms themselves as well. Oh, the lack of symptoms was a wrong conclusion, possibly. Okay, okay. Kids going crazy. Kids are going mad. Going mad over here. Let's have a look. Can we see the mountain from here? I think so. Okay, they appeared symptom-free, I see. Yeah, right. Who were the people buying all the toilet paper in Hong Kong? Yesterday morning, I saw a lady with a shopping trolley with 3 packets of toilet paper. I think it looked like 3 packets. But then I went in the supermarket she came out of and there was absolutely nothing. And nothing today also. All the supermarkets here. don't know if you guys notice, but out here you'll get people from the local restaurants. They'll come into the supermarket and then buy all of a specific thing. They'll buy everything. So I'm wondering if it's like restaurants going and buying all this stuff. Oh, usually a three sale. I see. Okay, Sada, thanks, man. Have a good day or good evening. So, yeah, I haven't pooped for 3 days now. So, depending on how I feel today, I may attempt to restring an acoustic guitar. It may or may not happen, I'm not sure yet. So, I have this Ibanez acoustic guitar that I probably bought about 20 years ago. And, you know, I played it a little bit, but it's basically never been played. So, it's just been sitting in its case. The neck is really dried out, and it's got the original strings on it. And the frets are kind of tarnished. So there's a bit of a slight restoration involved as well. Dude, I usually only buy one roll of toilet paper, maybe two, because three's too much to carry for one person, especially if there's other shopping as well. Do you get your groceries delivered? Give me a second, I'm just gonna go boil the kettle. Hey Luther, what's up man? Just gonna boil the kettle, be right back.
Play that. Hey, play that Ioni tune you wrote. Not the one you played earlier.
My one?
Latest one.
Have you been playing on Simple Man?
I played that once.
It sounded fucking great to me.
I had to do it for a competition. It was a...
Oh, that's why you did that?
Yeah. Never
play
that
Play
song.
The latest one you wrote. What? That latest one you wrote.
We should be back now. I just discovered that song a couple of weeks ago. It, for some reason, it showed up in my YouTube homepage, and it was like, yeah, what is this? And it was like, oh my god, this song is awesome. So we'll hang outside for a little while, then we'll head in a bit later. Maybe I'll do some cooking as well, who knows?
A World of Warcraft guy waiting to give a quest. Your pew pew stick, I like that. Where did my cat go? Right, Porgers. Yeah, I never played. I remember
before I left to come to Hong Kong, I'd bought a bunch of Warhammer miniatures and started painting them all. But then I left to come to Hong Kong before I even ever got to play and finish painting them.
V451.
So the neighbor, right? The neighbor used to have a barbecue just behind the fence here, and the heat and the smell used to come straight into my place, so I asked if he could move it. So they moved it down there, but now they put this pot plant palm tree thing here that's kind of blocking the view, but hey, what can I do? Yeah, I had one friend that was into it. And yeah, he'd been playing Warhammer for years. I don't know if he ever played D&D, but he definitely played a lot of Warhammer. I'm not sure if I ended up losing all my Warhammer miniatures or if they ended up getting shipped over here and somewhere in storage. I don't know. But I don't really want to go buy the paint and stuff again and start painting them. I guess it's something I could do on stream, but it's a bit time consuming. There's other stuff I need to do. Black lotus? A black lotus flower? What? What is that? A black lotus car?
Oh,
Magic the Gathering. Okay. Yeah, I'm not familiar. I know of it, obviously, but yeah, I'm not aware of the cards or which ones are rare. That sounds like one of the rarest. That is crazy. That is crazy. Yeah, I think somewhere, I think in storage as well, I got some cards and stuff, but not Magic the Gathering. I think I got some Star Trek cards or something. It's just the neighbor next door. No need to panic. So I listened to a conspiracy podcast just before the stream today. They went over a whole bunch of stuff, but one of the things they went over, a couple of things, they went over like space and flat earth, blah blah. But apparently the Big Bang theory was a priest in the Vatican came up with that theory, apparently. And what else? Oh yeah, they talked about Epstein. And you know how Epstein was given that, you know, that multi-million dollar house? Well, the people that owned the house before the guy that gave it to him was the Vatican. I haven't looked this up myself, but this is what they were saying. Little birthday cat, your brother's a nerd. Said several million from his estate disappeared. Man, this, it all goes so deep that there's literally not enough time to research everything.
Wow.
Wow, 21 Celsius. I guess it feels about that. I guess it was a little cooler earlier. That was so lucky.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Actually starting to get a little bit hungry. don't know if I want to cook up the steak though, or save it for dinner. Cooking would be the smart way, but if I cook these steaks, I gotta work out what to have for dinner then. Let's see. Okay. Definitely not cooking. No. What are we gonna do? We'll head inside in a minute. Let me start bringing this gear inside. Two mints for roughing, hey man. Yeah, edibles? I don't know. I'd have to ask my girlfriend if there's any edible stuff. Up here, I don't think so. Maybe down there, there's some bushes that are half dead that may grow some stuff, but yeah, I don't know. This is a mango tree. Actually, this is a mango tree. Yet last year was the first time it ever got mangoes, but it only grew like a handful, and they ended up getting diseased or something. And I see that there's some flowers again starting, so maybe this year we can actually get one. I don't know. And there's another, that tree up there also has these fruits called longan, but it's up so high, we can't get them. Anyway, let's go inside. Yeah, I love mango. I love mangoes. I'm just trying to work out what I'm gonna eat. Yeah, please, just one mango, I'll be good. What's the time? 12:30. Maybe I'll cook some veggies. Oh, you will be home for lunch. D- Damn. I probably should get you to get me a chicken doner with rice. I think I want that. For breakfast? For breakfast? It sounds good though. Does sound good. Oh wait, you made that, Zav. Is that like vegetarian? Is that like no meat? Damn, little birthday cat's coming home. Ah, no meat. It does sound good, man. I haven't done that for ages. Like, get the big pot and then just put all stuff in there and then put it on the stove. You try to eat meat 2 to 3 times a week. Wow. Wow. You made some pulled pork today? Sounds good. Thank you, birthday cat. Thank you. So I guess I don't need to cook anything then. That's good. I like that. Okay. I haven't watched CJ for quite some time. Just haven't really had a chance. Let's go over here. Okay, I know. Let's do this. Let's do this or I'll never do it. Someone is trying to extort him? What the hell? What the fuck? I hope that's not true. What on earth? Oh man, that's crazy. That's so crazy. It can't be real. I don't know. We don't talk about these things. Okay. Little birthday cat, I'm borrowing your, I'm borrowing little birthday cat's neck massage or neck support thing, whatever this is.
Shackles.
Alright, so this is it. This is the guitar that I was talking about just earlier. It's like 20 years old, basically never been played. And yeah, it's about time I change that. I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing. I'm probably gonna have to look at a YouTube video. I just hope I can do this like in one go, in one session. And let's move the camera. I might actually get this stool to sit on. So if anyone is interested in guitar stuff, Two Mins for Roughing, that was in the chat before, that's what he does on his stream. Just repairing guitars. I'm kind of stealing his content right here. What happened to his viewers? They bots. I don't know. 108 megapixel camera. Bro, learn a 3-chord song on it, then bring it to the hostels and play it. Oh my god. So, what do we got? So, I think the fretboard is kind of dry. It's kind of horrible. These are the original strings as well. So we should probably... I can't play guitar either. Not too bad. But trying to move your fingers is terrible. Let's do this, or like I said, I'm never gonna do this. We've got strings. We got some strings. We've got this little tool that I made, and we've got a winder, a cutter, and other stuff we need. Yeah, it's the fingers don't really slide along there very well. I guess it's not that bad. It has been in the case the whole time. I don't know if the light shows it, but the fretboard, it seems extremely dried out. It's not cracked or anything. I don't even know if I'm showing this on the camera. So yeah, it was a entry level guitar, pretty much, as I remember the price. But yeah, let's hope I can do this. So I guess first things first, I want to take off the strings, right? So I guess I just start loosening the strings. I'm gonna take them all off at the same time. I read a fair bit of info about that, and I think it shouldn't really matter. As long as it's not left off unstrung for a long period of time, it should be fine. Yes. So I've got this stuff right here. This Dunlop 65 Ultimate Lemon Oil. I got that. Yeah, hopefully we'll be good. I got these wipes. I'll give it a wipe down, perhaps. I'm fairly sure this should be safe. Loosen, then use the clippers. I've got a Linksys. Yes, you can see my Linksys. 1900 AC, version 2. So let's loosen them off a bit more, and then we'll clip them off. But I need to look at a YouTube video. Hang on, I was going the wrong way. I need to check a YouTube video for doing the strings at the tuning heads or whatever they're called. Okay. They're basically loose. Yeah, hopefully we're all set. Hopefully it's good. So this packet that my girlfriend got me, it looks like it has a cutting tool in there. Let's see if it works. And where do I cut it? Like anywhere, really, I guess. You can talk me through it. Okay, it cut the small string. Okay, clip at sound hole, watch the ends. Thank you. Good call. Let's watch the ends. I'll hold on to it, make sure it's good. Man, I didn't think that these things would cut, but they're cutting it perfectly. Amazing. This will be interesting. I hope none of these are stuck. So let me unwind it up here. Whoops. Let me remove the top of the strings and dispose of them. Wow, man. Nice. Just a moment. Excuse me. Yeah, yep, that's done. Let's see what the story is here. I guess I can use this tool. Apparently it does have the notch. But I kind of want to try put my hand underneath and just see what the... Oh, they come straight out. Oh, wow, they come straight out. Oh, that first one did. Second one straight out. Third one. Fourth one. Fifth one. Sixth one. No problem. No problem. I'm just having a look on how this exactly is. We got this. 2 mins for roughing. We got it. We got this. I was worried these might be stuck. Yeah, yeah. These pins have a groove, which it's gonna work like this. Okay, let me take these out, right? Okay. Next step, I'm going to use one of these things and wipe down the fretboard. Oops. I think the top there might be some dirt from finger. This is non-alcoholic, non-alcoholic, no fragrance, blah blah, baby wipes. Let's give it a good cleaning. May as well. Yeah, so this shouldn't dry it out at all anymore. I'll clean down here as well. I have never done this before, obviously. I have changed a string on an electric guitar before, but just one string, you know, a couple of times. Nothing like this. Never acoustic guitar. I don't know if I'm going to be playing it, but hopefully it's going to be nice and clean and more playable. You like the color? You know, there could be a reason why I didn't really play it, is because I bought it, right? I bought it and I really loved it, the color. And then I saw a music video with like Nick Carter or someone playing a blue guitar, and I was like, oh my God. I just thought of that every time I looked at it. Now I'm kind of past that, I guess, though. Alright, let's Alright, let's wipe it down. Hey, double R. Hey, Samos. Did the buzzer go off or not? Mate, I don't know if the sounds are working.
Wow.
At least I didn't say Hannah Montana. Oh, Samos. The sound effects now are only for sub, except for fart and maybe quack or something, perhaps? Alright. Yeah, I just recently changed the sound thing. Okay. I think we're somewhat good. The frets and stuff, I think they're okay. So, I made this thing. That, this is gonna hide the fretboard and expose the fret. I'm thinking of trying to polish the frets. And I'm thinking maybe I do that before I apply any lemon oil. It looks like a nice guitar. It's in good condition, but it is just a cheap guitar though. Man, the neck is so dry. The fretboard is so dry. It's kind of hard to see. Too bright. Anyway. So I got this. I'm thinking the frets, they need polishing. I got this thing. It has these soft pads. I'm wondering if I connect the soft pad to the bootleg Dremel, I'm going to be able to polish the fret with it without any, it's 20 years old now, vintage, makes it worth more. Steel, I don't think we have any steel wool or sandpaper. That is the thing. Wait, let me check. I don't know if this is gonna be really suitable. Hey, what was that?
What is that?
Hey, Don Vito's Boyle, thank you. The buffer pads might be okay. I got this. It's like I just got this one piece of wet, dry sandpaper, 280. I think I'm more comfortable just trying the pads. Yeah, I don't think I'm that. I don't know. But yeah, maybe I try the buffer pad first just to see what it's like. Okay. Gotcha, two mins. Now I've got a. This thing is not battery. I gotta plug it in. Something like that. The wet dry might be too aggressive. Yes, I seem to agree. So, Samos, yeah, like I said, it's probably about 20 years old. It's basically really never been played. It had the original strings, so I'm gonna change the strings. The fretboard, I mean, it had been in hot Australia for many years, so it's probably dried out a little bit. So I'm gonna try to restore the fretboard a little bit with this special guitar oil, fretboard oil, and replace the strings. That's the plan. I've never done this before. Okay, PowerPoint. Is this too far? That's too far. Down here. I got one. Need a China adapter, but I got one right here as well. Get in there. Why you no go? Okay, low speed. If I pull this off, you're gonna send me work. Stone Teen 420 high. The inside of the guitar should be fairly good. It's been in the case the whole time, pretty much. I think the inside is fine. So, here we go. We got the fret protector thingy that I've made. Let's start at the top, I guess. I got a rubber band. I googled this. I got a rubber band to attach it. Oh my god, that's so perfect. Well done, Days. Well done. Weird lighting. It's an old guitar. We're changing the strings. And we're gonna oil the fretboard and try to polish the frets. I've never done this before. So here we go. I'm gonna see if just this pad can polish the fret a little bit. It's on low. Let's see. Whoa! I accidentally. Yo, what happened there? Hold on. I thought it sped up. Wait. Let me get my more magnified glasses. This is five head right here. Hang on, does this thing change direction? Can I change the direction on this? I don't think so. I don't think I can. The rubber band! It got stuck in the rubber band! It's good. It's okay. Don't panic. It was bound to happen. Alright, we'll go no rubber band. I think it's working though. I do think it's working. Little bits of dust are flying everywhere, but it's okay. You can tell I've never used this before either. Let me check this. It's actually nicer. It is nicer. It worked. It's working. Hey, Narcotian. We're trying to do a mini restore job on this old acoustic guitar. Okay, second fret, let's go. Oops. A little more. Thank you. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, it's working. It's working. It's minimal, but it's working. This is gonna take a little while, but that's just how it is, I guess. Hey. How do I turn it off? Nice, nice. Sometimes the sounds get jammed up, but you don't lose the points. 1, 2, 3. Oh yeah, now I'm getting the hang of this. Nice, dude, nice. I could probably go over a couple of these other ones once or twice. Mate, I'm gonna be pro after I finish this. Speed holes. Maybe I might drill like all holes in the body to make it more lightweight. And it might be louder as well. More holes. It's like adding more speakers. nice. Yes. Yeah, this cheap guitar, if it was some expensive guitar, maybe I'd be more inclined to take it to them. But seeing that it's something cheap, I think it's a good opportunity to learn. I got this classical guitar here I found in the rubbish bins, and I'm gonna need to change those strings soon as well. One of them's about to break. So far, so good. Vintage. Vintage, not cheap. Vintage. Okay, so there's a definite improvement. It probably could be done better with something. I guess, if you got the right sandpaper, I guess you can get it like quite shiny. But as long as they're clean and smooth, I guess that's the important part. Yeah, the oil. Yeah, I'm hoping the oil will make a big difference. I hope. The fretboard seemed really dry and sticky, but not sticky. But yeah, dry and just not sliding at all. I think. Yeah, so let's hope. Hopefully, this stuff will be enough to get it back into a bit better condition. I might have to grab the vacuum. There's so much like bits of fluff off this little buffer. Oh yeah, I definitely need to get the vacuum. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight to go. Ah, my finger. My finger's getting locked up. We're getting there. We're getting closer. My finger. My finger's like locked up. This is serious business. This is serious business. She's never seen me so serious before. Cards fully buffed. I think that's the last one. Just go over a couple more, just to be sure. Hello.
Hello.
You can put my lunch up on the kitchen, please.
Okay. Is this tool okay?
Yeah. Okay. I'm just gonna grab the vacuum.
There's another connection for final work. Be like, sure. It's best that way.
Plenty of dust created from this. Probably should have been wearing my mask.
You better not be burning through your mask. Ah, today they had 600 boxes of masks available in Japan.
Ah, that's why there was a big queue.
Everyone got a box of masks.
Uh-huh.
And the cleaning lady from my work, when they fly, got two boxes.
Oh, really?
So not much.
This dust is probably going to be all over the place. Anyway, I think we're good for now. We should be good, we should be good to go. Alright, let me unplug this. Alright. Yeah, the frets, they're not like highly polished or anything, but they're a lot better than what they were. Much, much better. So I guess I need another cloth. Alright, so I got this stuff. I guess I spray some onto a cloth and then wipe it down.
Okay.
Remove strings, shake bottles, spray 1 to 2 pumps on cloth, work dirt and grime free and wipe away any excess. Not for use on maple fretboards. That's okay. So shake well. Let me get I'll just use this cloth. Hi, Pepper. Shaky, shaky. Here we go. So let me spray a bit on the corner of this rag. Hopefully the purple doesn't come out. Smells nice. Smells like lemon freshener. Oh, whoa. Whoa. Wow, it's, I think it's working. I think it's working. That's amazing. The purple might go with the blue. Cat wants to get outside. So I think I'm gonna take a break for lunch. Oh yeah. After I do this part and then come back for the restringing. I don't know if some of you guys may have to go to bed, but yeah, I'm gonna stop for lunch. Continue when I got some food in my stomach. The hard part's next. The hard part is next. It looks, dude, it looks amazing. I can't believe it. It looks amazing. I guess I should rub this stuff in pretty good. I know I gotta rub it off after, but I guess it was kind of super dry. Before... midway through. I guess it's not quite finished. I gotta rub it off. But yeah. Looking good. Looking mighty good. Pepper, it's okay. It's okay, cat. Hello. We're nearly good. Oh, now she wants out again. Let it absorb during lunch. Okay. Good plan. Let me give it a real good wipe down with this stuff. Let's not miss anything. Let's not miss any spots. Look, Nikki, look.
Oh, it's all nice and shiny.
Yeah, looks new.
You may want to polish this a little bit more.
It's fine.
I can still see a little bit of rust.
It's nice and smooth though.
Okay. I was gonna say I have vinegar to get it off, but not so good with wood.
Yeah, it's fine. That's fine. All right. Oh yeah, what do you call the bottom part? Okay, I think it's good. So, the oil might loosen some of the rust. Okay, okay. It's not, there's not really much tarnish on the frets now. So they're a little bit tarnished here, but no real rust or anything. So, yeah, I'll give it a good rub down after lunch when we come back. But guys, so for now, we've made this progress. The hard part's next though, putting the strings on. My only concern is I gotta watch a video quickly to attach these ends. Alright, thanks a lot, Two Mins for Roughing. Thanks for all your advice. So I'll be back in like an hour. I know a lot of you guys will need to go to bed, but I will continue this after I have some food. Thanks, man. The bridge, yes, the bridge. Sleeping, lol. All right. Thanks, everyone. Yep. I need to finish this today as well. I need to come back and do it because I shouldn't be leaving the strings off for extended period. But we'll be back. All right, guys. Thanks, everyone.